Must have started in 76, so.
So actually,
75, 76,
no,
yeah.
So has it, have you watched the entire change? I guess you weren't a journalist when you were at 77.
No, but I was an attendee, but yeah, I watched, you know, it used to be that if anybody showed up, like somebody from dinner theater showed up at the film festival back in the 70s, it was like, oh my God, we got to roll photographers, right? So we're sort of spoiled now because we get like 500 celebrity guests come through. But if one of the 500 don't show up, we get all offended, you know?
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah, we expect everybody to show up.
I remember about 7 years ago, I ran into Adam McGoyan. And he was just saying, you know, what's happened here? And we were just talking about, he said, I just was walking along the street, and he said, I was running because I had to make an appointment, and somebody yelled at me, oh, too good for us now. And he said, because there's this attitude that does what he said, and he just turned around and says, what are you talking about? I live here. What do you, you know, this is the street I walk on every day. And I said, oh, yeah, sorry.
You know? Now that's very Toronto, just to apologize.
Yeah, for yourself. But there, you know, this atmosphere of sort of artificial hype is mm-hmm. strange at times. Mm-hmm. It just doesn't feel like the city. And you know, there's different edges, different places. I mean, you can see a celebrity in New York City and people will ignore them, you know, because that's...
Or pretend to.
And I think most of the time Canadians are too polite to harass celebrities, but during the festival, they're fair game.
Yeah, you do get that gaggle of people around yes. the Intercontinental yeah. Hotel yeah. On, yeah. on Bloor, just mm-hmm. camped out there all day waiting for celebrities to do like a 2 second dash to the limo. Mm-hmm. It's very strange because when you're inside the hotel, you can actually go up on the second floor and just look down at this weird crowd hanging out.
Yeah, well, I love the Hazelden also, which I love that it's close to the name of the Hazelden Clinic. So this is appropriate that the expensive hotel is like, you know, drug rehab ultimately. But I remember a crowd, we went to go to, the, I think, a Starbucks across the street from here one day, 2 years ago when they first opened. And it was like, what is going on? Is somebody jumping out of the window? Is there a fire? No, George Clooney's in there. He's been in there for 4 hours. He hasn't come out yet, but they're waiting. And it was like,
he's got a, you know, a latte IV into his arm.
So is that part fun? I mean, does it change? What is Toronto a different place the week before and then the week after? Or is it?
Well, we had a major news event here happen a couple of weeks ago, yeah. right at the ground zero there. A former Attorney General of Toronto killed a bicyclist
in Ontario.
Very outrageous, Ontario.
Yeah.
Very outrageous case. That so it's been very exciting here.
We saw on Bloor.
Right on
yeah.
Bloor.
Yeah.
We saw a little some
the,
people.
The you saw the makeshift.
Yeah.
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 Yep.
Yeah.
Wow. That's the shrine to him.
Yeah. Pretty amazing story. Yeah. But actually,
was he a bad driver or was he?
Well, we, you know what? We don't know the details.
Yeah, we don't know the details.
Still being under investigation.
It's an amazing story.
Kind of like Michael Jackson.
Kind of like Michael Jackson.
Only kind of not.
Yeah. Yeah. But he still has his nose, though. That's it.
So you guys like yeah. just not worry about that for 2 weeks because of this?
Yeah, in a way, it's a funny time because, you know, there's always the thing I hear from the people in my neighborhood, my friends and rest of it, is like, God, I'm sick of the festival, when they're not even at it. I mean, they're just tired of the fact that it dominates the media so much mm. for that period.
It's like Olympics fatigue. It's the same type of thing that sets in. But we sort of lived this whole beast
yeah.
for so long yeah. that we're just living for September 20th.
Yeah. 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 For us, it's two-thirds of the way through, too, because the screenings yeah. do start yeah. so soon. Yeah. The first day of the festival, for us, feels like almost the last day. We're just almost finished.
Yeah, and the interesting thing too was there's the timing. It always it's like when Rosh Hashanah falls depends on the phases of the moon, and
yeah.
when TIFF opens fall depends on Labor Day, of course, right? So Labor yeah. Day was late this year.
Yeah.
We had an extra week, mm-hmm. and for some reason, I don't know if people were saying you're going to have more wiggle room this year, but I didn't think so. I thought people got crazy a whole week.
They started
earlier.
The screening
term. After yeah. extra week of frenzy is what.
Yeah, it yeah. was just it's just.
I used to say
crazy.
It was a month long festival. Because it feels like it's actually 6 weeks. It's like
yeah.
6 weeks now.
Yeah.
It started.
Or closer to 2 months now,
yeah.
really.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which doesn't really happen in a lot of other cities. I mean, it's when you look at the festivals that are in New York,
yeah.
the New York Film Festival is a very specific group of people. And
yeah.
Yeah.
Tribeca is not ever kind of eaten the city in that
yeah.
way. And,
I'm sick
you know.
With envy for the New York Film Festival. What is it, 22 films? That just sounds like
yeah. And even in Cannes, the night before Cannes, they go around putting all their flower pots down. The trucks all come down and just very efficiently lay the flower pots in front of the Palais de Festival. Like, mm-hmm. You've been there
yeah.
before?
Yeah.
They just carry on. Yeah.
So it's really a small town.
It's a small town.
I mean, Toronto
yeah.
is a big town.
Yeah.
And mm-hmm. I mean, LA, none of our festivals have any real profile beyond
it's,
what we're desperate
right now, it's really unwieldy because it's spread out more than it should be. Right? You've got stuff happening down the road, York, which is like a couple of kilometers that way. And it's just, you know, but I think once the Bell light box opens, it'll be interesting to see all everything shift south and hopefully center around that.
But a brilliant new thing this year is they've given a transit pass.
They have.
Which is so you can travel between all the venues for free while you're there. Anyone down in here?
Apparently, courtesy of our provincial government.
Yeah. That's fantastic.
Yeah. Yeah. So we don't get too many presents from that.
It's not as unwieldy as Sundance.
Yeah.
It's
you think Sundance is more unwieldy?
I definitely think so.
It's not as wet.
You spend a great deal of your time riding on shuttle buses at Sundance, which is it's not. You could hang out at the Varsity and do a pretty good festival. I mean, you don't have to travel that much. Yeah.
Well, it's such a big festival, you really could have one of any three or four different festivals.
That's right.
And really not touch the other ones.
Yeah, that's an excellent. No two people are seeing the same.
That's an excellent
festival.
Point.
You're seeing, you're all seeing different things.
There's festivals, circles within circles, all the way through it.
Yeah. If you look at something like Cannes, when we go to cover Cannes, we're all pretty much doing the same thing. They're all the competition films, and there's a press conference for each one that follows directly afterwards. Mm-hmm. And you're sort of locked into that, and you might sort of try and get out and do the odd other film if you can. But there's kind of a marching order that is set by the festival. Mm-hmm. And in Toronto, it's much more of a free-for-all, especially with everything loaded into the first weekend. There, you know, I'm interviewing probably a third of the people that I'd really like to interview because they're all doing their interviews at the same time. So it's like, well, I'd like to talk to you, but
I've got to see a movie too.
Exactly. That's the other. I want to ask you a question about perception. Up in the Air is like supposed to be a world premiere here, right? But it
kind of.
Yeah, but it.